Upanishads. We get an insight from Upanishad, and that is Tena Taktena Bhunjitha Yavata Dhyate Jatram. That means whatsoever I need, I must fulfill that. I need some resources, I need shelter, I need food, I need business, I need lot of money. Yes, you are free to earn. Our Indian culture says that you are free to earn whatsoever you want to earn. But you can only earn up to that level that is needed for you. If you are trying to take the needs of others, if you are collecting more than the needs, that is an offense. This is what our ancient wisdom has suggested us. Now, from where you can say that it's a new world. You can only collect up to that level. Let us move to the third perspective. Patanjali, in his Ashtang Yoga, the first chapter is Yam. In that Yam, he says, Satya, Ahimsa, Asteya, Aparigraha, Brahmacharya are the five things that are covered in Yam. The fourth thing, that is Asteya and Aparigraha. Aparigraha means you are not supposed to collect more than what you need. Jain Samaj, when we study about Jain literature, they are going to give you Panch Mahavrat. The Panch Mahavrats are also one and the same. Satya, Ahimsa, Asteya, Aparigraha and Brahmacharya. Aparigraha is the most important thing, and the word Aparigraha means don't collect the more and more from the society. Return it back. If you go to Islam, this is not merely Hindu culture. If you go to Islam, the Muslim says, Ya Khuda Kharch Badha. Kharch Badha, the expenditure should increase. If the expenditure increases, that means I am able to do something better for the society. Islam says about Zakat, 2.5% of the income should be provided to those underprivileged people who are suffering from diseases, suffering from problems. Are they getting the same? If you go to Guru Granth Sahib, jo drada rakhe dharam ko tahe rakhe kardar, and the basic dharm is to give back, contribute back for the society. What is your contribution today to the society? Think about it. If you are not contributing anything, you are a worthless and useless person, according to our side. Because there is no contribution to the society. What is your contribution? Have you ever thought about it? From here, the concept emerges. Friends, then comes the recent aspect. From where? Ethical awakening through dharma. Dharma means, dharma is not religion. The word dharma means dharyati ki dharma. Jo dharan karne layak hai, wo dharma hai. That is called as dharma. Now my question is, dharma is not merely religion. What you are going to do with that dharma? Dharma means when somebody needs something more than me, I am supposed to provide it to that man. Are we doing so? This is the first question. You can study the letters of Kumar Mangala, of G.D. Bilda, what he wrote to the grandson and sons of him. They insist that you are supposed to give it back to the society. Are we doing so? This is the question. Corporate social responsibility does not merely mean giving donations to the society. CSR means what you have earned, you are supposed to give it back. Are we doing it? This is the prima facie most important thing. The first is dharma. Second comes guilty consciousness gives rise to CSR initiatives. Guilty consciousness. I am feeling very guilty. I have 10 pairs of shirts, 10 shirts, 12 trousers, and a lot of things are there with me. Poor persons are not having. I feel I should give something to them. This is the second style from which it emerges. These are the two aspects one should try to understand. What is your area of thinking? Think about it today only. Friends, let us move to the modern world. This was the ancient wisdom that I talked about. Let us go to the modern world. When we started business, initial stages when the business started, there was the first law, and the law was called as the law of the jungle. Law of the jungle means the lion comes, everybody goes inside. Law of the jungle means might is right. You are doing business, if you are having lot of resources with you, you can do whatsoever you want. Previously this was there, when only there was some monopoly. Recently monopolies does not exist. Previously in car market, automobile market, you can go to shampoo, you can go to any FMCG market, there were some monopolies. Now there is no monopoly, it is perfect competition. Perfect competition means you are having different choices. When I was a youngster, at your age, when I was studying in MBA, in MBS University, Ajmer, there was only one bank where I was supposed to open an account. Few banks were running. Now I have different choices. And due to this, there is a lot of improvement in all the functioning of banks. This is what I personally believe. So law of the jungle has been abolished today. And we moved to second stage. Second stage was anything for profit. Profit ke liye kuch bhi karega. I can do anything for profit. Society is at number 2 standard. I am at number 1. I can do anything for profit. You might be knowing about different examples. Previously, one of the students, when I used to teach my students, one of the students told me, "Sir, when you were teaching me, you taught us that customer is the most important thing. Consumer is the boss. What's going on today?" I told, "Today also, consumer is the boss. But the problem is, previously we used to cheat them. Presently we cannot cheat them. This is the difference. How the cheating occurred? Previously you used to say, Hero baalon mein ronak laaye, baalon ko resham se banaye. Hero shampoo. This was the advertisement. Mahine mein do baar Hero shampoo karna na bhulein. It is started from that place. And nowadays the same company says, Din mein ek baar to karna hi chahiye. Now see, whether it is harmful or harmless, nobody says about it. But we are targeting our market in such a way that sales should be patronized. Anyhow, whether it is harmful or whether it is useful, we are doing anything for profit. We want to maximize the sales. We are trying to generate the demand in the market. Unnecessarily, uselessly, we are generating the demand. This is against the ethos of business.